What's going on, you guys? My name is Zach Hartley, and today we are talking about the VIX, or the Volatility Index. Okay, so let's get straight into it. What is the volatility index? Well, some people refer to it as the fear index. Basically, what volatility means is that prices are going to change. Nobody knows what's happening. Nobody can predict what's going to go on in the future, and that equals risk. That equals people losing money and not knowing what to do. Therefore, when the volatility is high and this volatility index is high, people hedge their bets. What that means is that if you own a long position or you own equity in Apple, you may want to place another bet so that if you're wrong on Apple and the price starts to go down, you will not lose as much money. Now, one of the ways that a lot of investors do that is by buying put options. What a put is it basically the option to buy the stock at a specific price on a certain day. Therefore, you can make money when that stock goes down. And so a put option hedges your risk on the downside. So if you own Apple and you own a large position in Apple and you want to limit your downside risk, you can buy a put option so that you make money even when that stock goes down. Now, what the VIX is it compares the S&P 500 or the broad market to the amount of put options in the market. What it's saying is, here's where we're at and here's how many people are hedging their bet. When a lot of people hedge their bet, the VIX skyrockets because it's not sure what's going to happen. When there's less hedges in the market, people are happier to own equity because they know what's going to happen. Therefore, the VIX starts to sink and drop lower. So the VIX refers to the broad market compared to how many people are hedging the market. That's all it is. And it basically shows you how much concern large investors have about the future of the stock market. So people hedge with options, and it's the comparison of the S&P 500 to the number of options in the market. Now, this is the formula for the VIX. It's pretty complicated, and when you extend it out, it goes what seems like forever. So, but I'm not going to dive into it. I kind of gave you the summary there. And what I want to do is show you how we can use the VIX in our trading. So the VIX represents implied volatility or risk. Therefore, when the VIX goes up, it means that the market generally goes down. And when the VIX goes down, the market generally goes up because there's more confidence in the economy and the ability of these companies to make money. So here's just an example of the last 6 months and what's happened. All these stocks are up to today's date. So great example of right in the market. When COVID hit, it hit at its peak at the middle of March. And so on the left side, we can see the VIX here. It looks just like a normal stock chart. Steady in from the bottom left, going into March, it starts to absolutely skyrocket and it peaks at the height of COVID in the middle of March. And then it slowly basically drops off to about 31 points. Now, if you look at the other chart here, the S&P 500, it is the complete inverse of this graph. You can see it's pretty high starting out, and then coming into March, it completely plummets. That's because the volatility and the risk in the market, as shown by the number of put options in the market on the VIX, is going and skyrocketing compared to the volatility, and the risk in the S&P 500 is completely plummeting. So the VIX goes up, the S&P comes down. Really simple. And here's another example of it. So this is the VIX compared to the Dow Jones Industrial back in 2011. Super steady on the left-hand side here. And then July hits. And by August, we have completely spiked and almost tripled on the VIX. And then if you look at the Dow Jones Industrial, you can see pretty steady coming in. And then July hits. August comes around and we have completely plummeted. So the exact inverse of the VIX again. So as you can see, it's a great telltale sign of when this VIX is going up, the market is usually going down. Therefore, we can use it as confirmation of our trades. So in summary, when the VIX goes up, the market goes down. When the VIX goes down, the market goes up. Therefore, you can say, okay, if you think the Dow Jones is going to go up over the next month and the VIX is going down pretty steadily, you're probably right and you can probably have a little bit more confidence making that trade. However, if you think the Dow Jones is going to go up over the next month and you're investing in some blue chip stocks, but you also see that the VIX is starting to creep up and creep up even faster and faster, well, you should have a lot of hesitation in that trade. You should double check all of your math and all of your assumptions, and you need to really think about what you're doing, because when that VIX goes up, history has shown that the market usually goes down. Therefore, we use the VIX to determine the market direction and the market sentiment of large investors that control the stock market. So It compares the S&P 500 to out-of-the-money options, and it is the fear index, and it's primarily investor-driven. The reason I say that is because you have to be buying put options to have any impact on the VIX index. So not many people are buying put options. No beginner traders, no basically entry-level guys, and not many retail traders are going to be buying put options to hedge their investments. Only advanced traders and wealth are actually going to do that. Therefore, this index is primarily investor driven, but it is driven by the majority of the market. And that's why it is important. And that's why it's a great indicator of what's going to happen in the future. So I hope you got some value out of this video. I hope you learned something. And if you did, please remember to show a little bit of love. I sincerely appreciate it. And I hope you have a great week trading. Bye for now.